we're going to take a break from some of the tutorials and some of the how-to type stuff and get into some more technical things tied to your site's performance, performance in terms of how fast it loads, performance in terms of how well it ranks in search engines. So this is going to get a little more nerdy, but we're going to have some fun, and I was pretty excited to find this, so I wanted to share it with everybody. So we're going to take, and keep in mind, we do a lot on WordPress.com to already optimize site performance, so I'm not going to get a terrible score here, but I'm going to show you there's a website that's called web.dev/measure. You can see it here. It's a tool Google put together. It ties into a bigger platform for measuring page performance that they use, that they make it available for other people to use, and that they factor into kind of how your site is scored for search rankings. So most people who have a website are interested in getting traffic, especially through organic search, so rankings tend to be pretty important. So what I'm going to do is just drop the URL for one of the sites in here. I'm going to use my band site. And it's going to process, it's going to check that URL, it's going to check the different pages on the site, and it's going to tell me what's wrong with it, essentially. It's going to say, here's how you're performing, how that compares to other websites, here's what we can detect in terms of issues, and it's going to give me a breakdown. Now, one of the really frustrating things about this report is that some of the things that it will tell you are not easy to fix if you're not a developer. Some of them are super easy to fix, some of them are not. And it tends to give you a lot of the same thing if you're checking it across different sites. So it's gonna say JavaScript, it's probably gonna tell me the embeds. Yep, so we have embeds from different players that maybe I have on the site or videos, render blocking resources. So this is technical stuff. This is talking about the JavaScript and the CSS that make your site look the way it looks and interact with you the way that it does, or interact with your viewers the way it does. So it gives you a breakdown of all these technical things, like different files that are in there and everything too. So red is bad, yellow is what I'd call pretty bad, and green is good. So from a performance standpoint, that site is not doing great, probably because I have a lot of third-party embeds on there. If you've ever added like Facebook embeds or YouTube embeds and things like that to the site, sometimes it can give you a lot of these errors. If you go back up to the top though, overall the site is in great shape. So if I were to go drop those out of there and use something else, like maybe even upload them, the videos or the songs natively and use the player there, it would perform a lot better. But when it's trying to talk to Spotify or it's trying to talk to Facebook or it's trying to talk to YouTube and then get all that information back and play it on the fly, it takes a lot more time. So nothing too crazy, but what you'll see is a lot of technical things in here that are not great, that are hard to understand and that may not mean anything for you and that would be probably hard for you to do without some developer help. Now, this tool I had almost forgot about, and I'm kind of surprised every time I come back to it. It's called Boost. It's by Jetpack. So I'm going to go down to my Jetpack settings. I'm going to click on this Boost link. And it's going to be kind of a similar thing overall. It's telling me what my scores are. It's giving me desktop versus mobile. But watch this. You don't have to hire a developer. I can just tell it to optimize my CSS. I can look at this defer non-essential JavaScript, means that my website won't wait for that extra JavaScript, probably embeds a lot of it, to load on the page first, because all that has to respond to everything. So it'll start loading my page and rendering my page and basically process that JavaScript in the background. So that might mean that somebody goes to it, they load up my website, and then the player pops up, or then an embed pops up. From a search engine perspective, they call that layout shift or cumulative layout shift. That's not a great thing, but when the trade-off is your site's performance and load time period for all of your content, or what they would call the largest contentful paint, versus some layout shift, I would go with getting the rest of your content loaded so people can actually engage with your site. So I'm gonna go ahead and defer that. Lazy loading images. It's kind of like a magical thing that people take for granted. It's not loading all the pictures on the page until they think the user is scrolling and going to see them. Because again, if you wait till everything on a page loads, depending on how much content is there, depending on how high quality your images are and everything else, it could take a long time to pull all that in there, especially with embeds and stuff. When you lazy load it, the site tries to load the things that are in view first and then loads the next things as the user is scrolling towards them so that the user will still see them from their perspective. Ideally, they won't have to wait for anything to load, but it's not using resources to try to pull all that at the same time. And on WordPress.com, we also have a really cool tool, which I'll probably dive into in a different video when I can speak to it more technically. It's called Photon. It does image optimization on the fly. So it takes the image you upload and it creates all these different versions you might need across the site and optimizes them for the different screen sizes and everything. And it ensures that it's only loading the image that the user needs based on what device they're on, what size of screen they're on, and all that good stuff. So it's not loading like a poster size image for somebody who's on a little mobile phone. And that's pretty cool technology. So you get some insights here too. And so these are simple, like really when you look at it, there's only a few options in here, but you don't have to hire a developer to fix these things. This is three toggles to turn on. Nobody has to implement anything. Nobody has to add code, none of that. And this should, if I go back and test this, say in a week or so after it's crawled again in Google, I would expect to get less errors and less red flags on that report. And I didn't even know, go back to, so $10 a month, you can actually upgrade and get CSS regeneration, performance scores that'll update on the fly, and then additional support. So if you wanted to be really aggressive, if you're trying to drive a lot of traffic, if you monetize based on your traffic and you're really reliant on organic search, that's worth looking into too. Again, that saves you from having to pay a developer to do all that CSS work. So not that it's a lot, like they're pretty small tasks. So I'm not trying to say, oh, it's impossible or it's too much work. It's tedious work. If you're not a developer, it's probably not work that you want to do. I don't want to figure out how to do all this with CSS, even though I have some technical skills. So check out Boost. The free functionality is definitely beneficial. You can consider the other functionality as well. And then, yeah, there's a number of other optimizations we do to your site. But if you're trying to figure out performance and you're trying to get your numbers from tools like this to go up, Boost is an easy way to do it.